Alright guys, and welcome back to Life is Strange Before the Storm. It really is. It really is strange. There's a forest fire that's been perpetually burning on the horizon there for at least two episodes of this series. But Chloe here has gained the keys to access the dormitory here, but just as she was about to open the door, Skip comes out. Skip the security guard, by the way. If you haven't seen the last episode, go back and watch it now. But Skip, we had to kind of humiliate him a little bit, and it was a bit of an awkward conversation because Chloe is friends with Skip, and she sort of made him kind of just quit his job. She's quite the talker. On we go. We're here on a mission for Frank, but let's get inside the dormitory. We have to find Chip's room for some reason. But you'll see that in a minute. Uh-oh. Leaving the key in the door. Classic mistake. But guys, thank you so much for coming back to watch this. I do hope you're enjoying the series. Don't forget to hit the like button if you are enjoying it, of course.
Alright, which one is Drew's room?
One ABFW alert? What's that? A fire weather update? Ooh, Arcadia Bay, Forest Watch. Culmination State Park fire now 50% contained. Additional road closures, check local media. Okay. Now we've got to find Drew's womb. Thou shalt not pass. Who the hell is that?
Could Elliot be lamer if he tried?
Yeah, that's definitely Elliot's room. Should we have a quick look
Elliot
inside?
Hampton's room. Wonder what he's up to.
Is he even here? Picture of Albert Einstein there on the wall. These look like little game characters, I think. Pretty cool. A clarinet, yes, of course.
I knew Elliot did well in class, but I didn't realize he was here on a full ride.
Oh wow, so he had financial aid completely. So he's here on a scholarship. That's really cool. Are we gonna use his computer? Is this okay?
Nice.
Just got a letter about your scholarship. Couldn't be prouder. Absolutely. That's from his mum.
Lucky Dana.
You got English with Dana Ward. What's she like? I think she's hot. Okay. So Logan Robertson has got the hots for Dana.
Warren Graham is such a nerd.
Warren. You'll know him from the first game, Life is Strange. You'll know all about Warren. I won't say any more. I've done a whole series on the original Life is Strange game. If you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's in the channel's back catalogue, so go check it out. Okay. Not sure how much more we're going to look at before we get on with the mission.
Afterward, summer strong at the broken places.
The biography of Hermit.
Sad.
Ernest Hemingway. I'm not sure I want to read a book. All right. It was fun. Let's get out of here. Okay, there's a number of doors I can try. Ah, Skatia Bay. I like what they did there. Break a leg tonight. Okay. This guy's in the Tempest, as was Rachel. And thanks to my heroics, admitting, you know, owning up to my crimes, Rachel was reinstated in her part in the Tempest. I hope we get a chance to see that. Is this his room?
Yep. Definitely Drew's room.
All right, shall we knock before we enter? Always polite, don't you think? Alright, well, I guess we can have a quick look.
Probably just get the money.
So that is why we're here. We're here to collect some money that he owes Frank. And Frank didn't want to come onto the campus, of course. And me, as an ex-student, would have made a more convincing infiltration. Wow, he doesn't even have a bed.
Drew's not here. Okay. If I were Drew, where would I hide my money?
Well, he has two beds in here. So a bed and a sleeping bag. I mean, he's been having guests in his room. Oh, the shock of it. Right, where would he hide it? Let's check the trunk.
Is the money in there?
If it is, it's locked. Then we may need to find a key. Oh, it's a combination lock.
Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code.
He's probably written the code somewhere.
A lot of numbers on here. Would Drew really use something like this for a...
1212. That's a possibility. 1212. That is definitely a 4-digit number. Let's give it a go, shall we? What a fool if he did do that. Oh, I think he did. All right, let's try 1212.
Damn it.
Okay, it's
wrong
not
numbers.
Bad. It's fine. We got plenty more to check. And we have a letter here. Mind you, let's have a look at the calendar. Sometimes people pick their birthdays, don't they?
I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
516, May the 16th, 2010. I don't think that's going to work out. 516. I need four numbers, really. What about
Holy
this letter?
Shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football.
Makes a lot of sense. August the 1st, 2009. That's just the date of the letter. What's this?
Plenty of possible combinations here.
Ooh. Drew North's birthday. And Michael North is in here as well. Well, Drew North's birthday is April the 3rd. That's the 4392. That's a possibility. His own birthday. April the 3rd, 1992. Let's try that. 4392. Okay, 4392.
Damn it.
Damn it.
Wrong numbers.
Okay, well, in that case, let's check out his computer.
I didn't
Maybe.
Realize Drew was this good at sports. I bet he can't wait to get out of Arcadia Bay.
Okay. And this one is from Drew North. Thanks for your consideration and the generous scholarship offer. I regret to inform you I've chosen to attend Oregon State in the fall.
Frank wasn't lying.
Hey, bro, do you have any more happy pills?
Happy pills to his fellow meatheads. So many folks are shit out of luck around here.
What an amazing game. Can't believe that third quarter conversion, you got moves. Okay. Okay, I don't think we've got any numbers in these. What about these gaming books? Figures?
Mikey's figures. Playing that game yesterday was actually fun.
That was pretty cool, actually, in part two. What about these comic books?
Durgron. Yeah, that fucker's dead.
Okay.
Bad guys don't usually look so obvious.
But Sergeant Blood versus Maniacal.
This is still awesome.
Actually, the drawing's really good.
Awesome.
Dr. Timebot, the Jurassic Edition. Nice. Okay. Sleeping bag. I'm not sure we're going to find a number in a sleeping bag. Ah, so Mikey's been staying. So that's his brother. We may have to look at his brother's.
They look so happy.
His brother's birth date instead. Interesting. Okay, his brother's birthday was down here as well. Let's have a quick look at that.
I wonder exactly.
516, Varsity Awards Dinner. I'm not sure he would have used...
516 is to Drew. Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? Plenty of possible combinations here.
Okay. So it wasn't April the 3rd. What about December the 27th? That's 12/27. That's his brother Michael's birthday. Let's try 12/27. Nope. Oh, it worked. It was his
yes.
brother.
This is kind of fun. Ah, Did little Drew beat you up, too? Jackpot.
Oh, nice.
I'm kind of good at this.
I'm not sure it's something you should be proud of. Being good at breaking into somebody's room, chest, and stealing their money.
Okay, got the money. Time to bust out of here.
Just noticed this poster. Yeah, definitely a boy's room. All right, we're out of here. I've got a feeling we're about to get caught. Oh, great. Yep, somebody else is coming in. Oh, hi.
Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
Oh, this is awkward. I'm looking for Drew.
I was looking for your brother, but he's not here, so...
Why?
Bro, we gotta go. Yesterday wasn't enough? You wanna go another round? Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff, let's move.
Drew, relax. Slow down.
Who's that?
Shit!
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
What's going on? That's exactly what I'll say.
What's going on?
Don't worry about it. Stay in here and don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
You know what's going on?
Damon, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Shit!
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look, it's spring season. We just started two-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me a grand. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now.
I heard about your dad's job, by the way. Tough times.
Yeah.
Bet a grand would mean a lot to him right now. Where's my money, Drew?
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm gonna...
Where is it?
Please! Just give me 1 week.
You're just going to lie there? I thought football players were supposed to be tough.
Sorry to have to do this, kid. No one steals from me. No one.
Fuck. Fuck.
Oh, give Damon the money or stay with Mikey. Oh, God. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? I'm going to have to... Oh, this is a big decision. I'm going to have to give Damon the money. I can sweet talk Frank, I'm sure.
Stop! It's okay. I've got your money.
Ah, I didn't realize we had an audience. Hey, Mikey. Okay. Who the hell are you?
Frank sent me to collect.
That's what Frank was going on about? Wait, are you the bitch who tuned up Sheldon?
That guy at the mill?
Oh, well, he needed it. Oh, yes, I remember now.
He was an asshole. He kept harassing me. He needed to get the message.
Frank was right about you. Let's see the cash.
We need that!
Oh my God. Oh, is he broken his arm?
It's all here. Mikey, you need to help your big brother. Help him understand that I take this shit seriously.
Come on! Mikey's got nothing to do with this, man.
You help your brother understand that if he steals from me again, I'm coming back here, and I'm going to break his knees.
It's perfectly reasonable.
Dude. Tell Frank I owe him one.
We needed that money. You just screwed us over.
Are you crazy? That guy could have killed you.
You don't know anything about this situation. It's none of your business.
Okay, so I was just doing my job. Seriously, that's not your job. You were trying to help. If Mikey's involved, it's my business. Hey, that's important. That's probably a good angle to come from here.
Yes, it is. Mikey's my friend. I don't want him to get hurt.
You think you're some kind of hero? Stepping in for poor Nathan Prescott? And now you're messing with our lives? Mikey, I gotta look at your arm. Just leave us alone.
Okay. What do I say nothing or say I'm sorry? Go on, say I'm sorry. Come on, be good.
Look, I'm sorry.
Sorry doesn't get our dad off the streets, does it?
Oh God, is that what they wanted it for?
We'll be okay.
Okay, feeling huge pangs of guilt, but at least that guy won't come back here and hurt them anymore, right? Was that the right thing to do? God knows. This game constantly makes you ask that kind of question. But that's the point. Moral choices, moral dilemmas. You're in a moment and you have a choice. You can help or do nothing. And it could be the wrong thing to do. Either of them, you just don't know how things are going to play out. But hey, such is life, right? Where to now, Chloe? We're gonna go back to tell Frank what happened. Oh, this is the set of the Tempest. I was kind of hoping we'd get to see a snippet of the performance there with Rachel in it.
Day has been so messed up.
At least I can talk to Rachel.
Okay. Talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back here.
Okay, so Rachel will be around here somewhere. Oh, look at the props. Awesome.
I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun.
I'm still not convinced that what I saw at the end of the first part of this episode, the first episode, was Rachel's using some kind of special power. And oh, there's a text from Rachel. How's your super long errand? Yeah, it's crazy. Happened in Drew's room. Yeah, really did. Really bad. What are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Yeah, later. Don't worry, until the show's over. I'm backstage. Yes, that's right. Let's make her worried sick so she forgets her lines. Okay, she's on her way. We can enter the tent. Okay,
Rachel?
Let's do that. Oh, no. Not Rachel. What is she doing? Is she trying to drug Rachel so she'll fall asleep and she has to take her part for herself?
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit. I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
Okay, we've got a message from Frank here. Hurry up, I just talked to Damon. Ah, good work. You can meet me tomorrow to pick up your cut. Your friend's an arse. Okay, sorry, I don't think I quite understood that. That Damon was there, actually, to collect the same money Frank was. And it was Frank who was actually going to pay Damon. So there we go. That all kind of makes sense, and it worked out. I did the right thing, according to Frank. Yes, I did. I saved my friend from getting beaten up. And we have one from Steph. Let me know if there's any way I can help. Thanks, I will. What happened here? Mikey's arm got broken. Oh, okay, not good. Drew told me a little what happened. I didn't know it was that bad. Yeah, the situation's... yeah, not good. Okay, that's interesting. Now, let's see exactly what happened here. She was messing around in the purse, wasn't she?
Only the finest child slave labor for Victoria Chase.
Nice, yes. That's her name, Victoria. Yes, never liked her. And this note.
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
Okay. See on me or Mr. K. Now, this tea, I'm expecting to be... oh, hang on, there's a purse there. Oh, no, it's the same thing. All right, but I can't do anything with it. So what am I supposed to do? Working mirrors, though, guys. Working mirrors. Excellent. Wow, that costume's amazing. Okay, now it's not giving me a chance to do anything. Oh, okay, but it said it was empty, so I'll pick it up anyway. Never mind. Pills. Aha!
Muscle relaxers?
Right, well, that'll be the ones that she put in the tea then.
Coming, Rachel?
Throw the tea away. What are you doing?
Hurry now before your tea gets... what are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only. Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
Okay, I'm here for Rachel.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever.
Don't drink the tea. Tell her now.
Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night, as a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks.
Right. Tell Rachel or distract Victoria. I'm just gonna tell her. Why would I want to just cover that up?
Wait up, Rachel. Bitch, dosed your tea.
Excuse me? How dare you?
Tell her to drink it then.
Could this possibly be true?
Of course not. A dropout Chloe is clearly directing her misplaced anger at me. I'm sorry your life is a mess. But it's not my fault, okay?
Chloe, Victoria is my friend. She would never do anything to sabotage me.
Then she should drink the tea. Absolutely.
Then she should prove it. Drink the tea.
What?
I wouldn't dare insult Victoria's integrity like that. Then again... if that's what it'll take to convince you that Victoria is a good and caring person, fine. Come on, Vic. Put dropout Chloe in her place once and for all.
Well? Is she gonna throw it on the floor and storm out?
Oh, happy?
So happy.
Whatever. If you're done accusing me of things, I'll just be on my way. Bitches.
Wow. Saved my ass again. Price. All in a day's work. And this has been a particularly batshit crazy day. Oh, hey, that's mine. The gloomiest shirt of the bunch. How did I know you were gonna pick that one?
I guess Prospera knows all.
Sweet Tarnation, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel. Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Yep, that's what you get.
Touché.
Brilliant.
What if the play's off?
No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The cynic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
Actually, no one's gone to see if she's all right.
Chloe,
she's just, yeah, she does it all the time. Oh, go on then. We'll have to do it. Come on. We of course we're going to do it.
Damn it.
Oh, wow. Looking good. Looking real good. What a costume.
Rachel's talked me into this.
So, do I have to learn the lines? I mean, that would probably be a good idea.
Have to memorize all of this?
Enter Ariel. Ariel, hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure. I boarded the king's ship in every cabin. I flamed amazement the fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring. The most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. Not a soul, my king's son. Okay, so I've got to kind of remember some of this stuff. Not a hair perished, and as thou baddest me. Okay. Is there more toil? I'm not gonna remember this. That's my little master's right, my liberty. Ariel Exita. Right, so we only have like seven lines. And I'm not gonna remember any of them. By the way, sorry if you hear bangs. It's fireworks night. Bonfire Fortnite here right now. And yeah, there's lots of booming fireworks going on outside. Okay. I think we're gonna go be in a play. Oh my god. Check me out though. What a costume. You could look a little happier about it, Chloe. Well, let's do this.
By accident, most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore.
Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose.
Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
Oh, here we go. I'm so nervous.
I'm ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it.
Oh, God. No, I'm not sure I'm ready. Okay, we're doing it anyway.
I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
I'm here. There's the spot. I'm on the spot. Right, speak.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure. Most fearless,
generous spirit, hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
Oh god, here we go. I boarded the king's ship. Yes, that's the line.
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried.
Oh, God, hell is empty. Hell is empty.
Cried, hell is empty, and all the devils are here.
Yes!
Every line delivered like a pro.
Safe? All right. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Oh, okay. Where do I walk? I could walk over... Where do I walk? I'm just going to keep wandering around. Look at the shipwreck.
I'm...
Oh, there it is.
Supposed to do something with this.
Chloe, stand here. Got it. Right. Yes, I'm going to. Right now. Got this. Oh, no. Come on, look. Oh, God, everybody's watching. This is so embarrassing.
Not a hair perished. And, as thou battest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In... Oh, loops, troops, or groups? Oh, God, loops?
In... loops?
By all the gods in heaven, when is Juliet getting here?
Oh, I think I got that wrong then.
Thy charge exactly is performed. But there's more work.
More toil.
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
Oh, God. Equality. Equality? Oh, God, I've totally forgotten.
My, equality?
No creature may come near to equal Prospera. That lies beyond my power to bestow.
Oh, okay. Liberty.
My liberty.
Thy liberty?
Yeah, I want my freedom. Make me free!
Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it? What's going on?
What is going on? But thou hast promised. Thou hast promised.
But thou assured my freedom, didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script.
It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Excitement isn't happiness. That's kind of nice.
Excitement's a mere counterfeit of bliss. These storms and these adventures, I prefer to know thou still cared for my plainest self.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
Then I'll run away.
Then there's no other choice. I'll run away.
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes. And when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty's forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased.
It was the only thing I could have said.
Done for now.
So go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
Thanks, Chloe.
Well done. An admirable effort. And the ending? Absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
No problem.
What the hell just happened? Strangeness of your soul. Was that real? What heaviness in
me. Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
'Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On!
Oh, wow. It's not just me that was nervous then. And Chloe, I think you did a remarkable job.
As wicked do, as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Shit.
He's crying.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
What's going on?
Fuck you.
Wow, that I don't remember that being in the Tempest.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard, like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
I'm not quite sure why he gets to take a bow. His one line, fuck you, was brilliant. Brilliantly delivered, said with meaning and passion. So believable. But yeah, Rachel, what a cracking job she did. I think Chloe should be brought on in as an honorary actress.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Woman, there she is. There, that's her again. I'm sorry, but she just really, really looks like Rachel Amber. to me. I don't know if that, it's just because they're similar. It's similar hair. I think that's what's doing it. But it looks like that could be Rachel in, like, what, 30 years' time, maybe? Maybe a bit more? But that's the woman that we saw our father with under the tree in the very, very first episode.
Oh, my God. Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself.
In the dead of night, I'll meet you in my sleep.
He was shitting himself.
That dude owes me.
In the morning light, you wake up next to me. Like a dream come true, I'll take you where I roam. And follow you back home. Tell me you care.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders? I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You know, you. Like, seriously. I love nights after a show.
Is it always like this?
Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first timer, are you proud of yourself?
Well, I'm definitely proud of myself, but more relieved, I think, is probably true. But just say definitely.
Yeah, I feel really awesome. If you told me this morning I'd be this happy tonight. You've gone through so much shit today.
Right now's pretty good.
Okay, the whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical.
Say something silly. Hold her hand. Say something sweet. Say something sweet. Go on.
Well, everything's been magical since we started hanging out.
Oh my God. Sorry, that was another firework.
Let's leave. For real.
For real, huh?
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night, let's do it.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day. But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell. You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Okay, middle of nowhere, parents, money. Yeah, all three reasons are good. But I'm going to go with, okay, fine, you win. Because we can. What? Why the hell not?
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
Wow, LA, the open road, or New York? Hey, the open road. Let's not decide right now.
I'm feeling like an indefinitely long road trip.
That sounds like the greatest idea anyone's ever thought of. You and me, driving down the coast, filling up our truck with hilarious souvenirs, and every night, we'll find a different beach to walk along and watch the sun go down.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
What's the matter?
Stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
Wow. Your bracelet, a kiss, or a tattoo? Okay. Why would I ask for a bracelet to prove what she's saying? Or a tattoo? I'm gonna go with a kiss. I think that's the best option.
How about,
Oh, I didn't even have to say.
Is that convincing enough?
I could be more convinced.
I've got to save something to bribe you with if you change your mind later.
I won't change my mind.
What if I said let's leave tonight?
Really?
You see the ash is falling down like snow.
What is this?
What do you say? Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff for my house.
For you or for me?
I gotta say, my clothes look damn good on you.
Cool. Let's do it.
And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay.
That sounds perfect.
Wow. What a cool house. Okay, so we've got to go basically pick up some clothes before we leave town for a long road trip. Well, you know, it's kind of not what I was expecting to happen by the end of this episode, but I don't know, we're not done just yet. And once again, I'm sorry about all those giant booms that keep happening in the background, if you can hear them through the mic, I'm not sure. But there are huge explosions going on outside at the moment. Are we really sneaking into our own house? Or is it me she's trying to sneak in?
Ah. Oh, you're home. Rose, Rachel's home. And she brought her new friend.
Our star returns. You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
Yes, it is.
Nailed it. I must have been pretty memorable.
You were. I get the sense that you're used to making an impression.
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Thanks.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must? I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
Okay. Not hungry or just leaving? Oh, hey, I'll just say, no, just leaving? Just leaving? Yes, go for that.
Thanks, but I was just gonna stop in for a sec and then bounce.
Oh, did you have other dinner plans?
Dinner plans? I always thought dinner was something that just sort of happens.
Chloe. I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
Okay, this is gonna get awkward really quick.
Okay, I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
Please come back quickly.
Just hurry back. I don't know how long I can keep this up.
Try doing it your whole life. And, Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know...
that I would normally say.
Exactly.
Just some quality time with the Ambers.
Wow, well that is interesting.
Possibly go wrong.
So, try not to say anything I would say. It's a good point. So guys, I'm going to leave it here. End the episode. I hope you've enjoyed it. I don't know how much further we've got in this particular chapter, which might mean that the next episode is quite short. We'll see. Totally unaware of the next step. So guys, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed it. Of course, subscribe if you're new to the channel and you want to see more. Other than that, guys, I hope you're having a wonderful day wherever you are. Take care, all the very best, and good night.